In the test kitchen, we're always looking to inspire you to explore new techniques. Today, we'll put a modern twist on an old family favorite by using the sous vide technique to make a chuck roast eat like a steak.
We'll use a simple blend of seasoning. As always, some coarse salt and cracked black pepper. The addition of onion flakes and granulated garlic will add a little extra flavor. For food safety concerns, fresh garlic has no place in a vacuum bag when cooking sous vide over a long amount of time. Make sure the roast is well coated in the seasoning before moving into the vacuum bag. To ensure that the bag stays clean, it's important to fold over the edges of the bag when adding the beef. This will keep a clean seal and prevent any leaks in the vacuum bag. Vacuum sealing and slow cooking really intensifies the flavors in the bag. Here we'll use a little rosemary and fresh thyme for some fresh herb flavor. You'll only need a couple of sprigs though. A little goes a long way in this application. You can use other hearty herbs that you enjoy or omit them altogether if herbs aren't your thing. Make sure that the vacuum looks tight and the seal looks good, and then it's time to get it into the bath.
This is the immersion circulator, which is the device that circulates this water bath, and the cooking technique is called sous vide, which technically means under vacuum. So we're cooking this in the vacuum bag. You could do it in a Ziploc bag, but when it comes to these long, day-long, two-day-long sous vide techniques, I prefer to do it in the vacuum bag. That way you're certain that you're not getting air or water into this steak, or you're not getting some of the juices from this going into your circulator. So I like vacuum bag for the long cooks.
We'll cook this at 131 Fahrenheit for 24 hours, which will come out a nice medium doneness. In the test kitchen, we like to use sous vide balls to insulate the water and help prevent too much evaporation. Some setups come with lids, but you could just use plastic wrap to create your own lid in a pinch. Now that it's cooked for 24 hours, you can see that it's lost some of the juices, but that's expected on a slow cook. It will still be juicy and the long cook time will help tenderize the chuck roast. The roast looks a little odd right now, but we're gonna fix that with a good sear. When cooking sous vide without searing first, the roast will look a little different, but we'll fix that by giving a good hard sear now that it's done. You can get rid of those herbs at this point. They've given all they have to the flavor of that roast. Patting the roast dry will help to create a good sear. Moisture on the surface prevents good crust development. Repeat the process on the other side as well. You'll want to make sure that the surface is as dry as possible. A light coating of neutral oil will instigate browning and help it along faster. You can use avocado oil, peanut oil, or any oil that won't burn at high temperatures because we're searing hot. Allow the pan or grill time to preheat before searing. You waited this long, so don't rush the preheat. Add just enough oil to coat the bottom of the pan, and when you see it start to smoke, add the chuck roast. I like to use a little weight to keep the steak in contact with the pan. This isn't a heavy weight that'll push out the juices, it's just enough to keep it in direct contact for a good sear. You can see that it has developed a great crust and it's only been a couple minutes in the pan. You'll want to sear the edges as well to help brown and render any excess fat. Now, this looks less like a roast and more like a giant seared steak. Time to slice it up and see how we did on the interior. Look at that nice pink center. It was cooked through at a high enough temperature to tenderize the steak, but low enough to keep it at a rosy pink medium. This steak has all the rich flavor of a ribeye infused with those fresh herbs. This is a great steak to serve family style to impress your friends with a different cooking technique for this cut. Now you can bust out your fancy flaky salt for the nice finishing touch.
I'm telling you, that is so good. It's got the flavor of those herbs pulled right into that chuck roast. And the flavor is just, it's steaky, it's beefy, but it still has that chuck flavor profile. But it's nothing like a chuck roast that you've eaten before. This recipe modernizes a classic cut like chuck roast and makes it an affordable way to feed a large group of people a great steak dinner. Join us again next time here in the Test Kitchen.